All right, so yeah, I'm just taking this piece of tube that you, it's the material you start with usually. You stretch it out a little. And then I'm opening up this end piece, which will be the piece I use to blow into. Cut off this end. So you got a nice little mouthpiece to blow through. And then you just take this, and I'm gonna basically pull off the section the size section that I want to use. So basically right now I'm just gonna heat this up nice and evenly and stretch it out into a point, which is what my left hand is holding on to, which I just opened up the mouthpiece on. So you gotta get a nice amount of this hot, because once you have a big heavy piece of glass on there, you don't wanna, you know, have a really thin short tube where you're burning your hand and your tube's gonna break if you got too much weight on there. So once you get it hot, you pull the point. Try to make it nice and even so the next one won't be all floppy and lopsided. That's pretty good. Could have been a little bit longer, but. And then I can take this end off, which is going to be the piece that I'm using to make. And then there's your point for the next piece. And this is what we're working with. And I try to make this end a little even as possible, so when I go to blow it out, it doesn't have a lump on it. So when you go to spin it out, it'll be round. Pull a little piece of glass off there. Make it nice and even. Make sure your mouthpiece is cooled before you burn your lips. And I'm just gonna heat this up a little and do a silver fume, which is makes blue and like yellowish and white and purple. And it's basically just a little blob of pure silver. Oops, stuck on at the end of a piece of glass. And you just go and heat that silver up real good and hold your piece in the fume that comes off of the burning of the silver. And then it, gotta make sure your piece is hot though, because it won't stick to it if it's not hot. You gotta get it nice and coated. So we got the silver fume. I'm gonna blow this into a bubble. Make sure you heat it nice and evenly, so when you go to blow it out, it all blows out evenly, and you wanna make sure you spin at an even constant pace, just so you don't heat one side more than the other. The gravity makes the bubble kind of come out more round or even smashed. And if you hold it down when you blow, you get the like elongated bubble. So there we go. Now we got a fumed bubble. I'm gonna pop a hole in the end. Heat up a little tiny spot real good right on the end. Just enough. Not too much of the glass, but just a little spot. And then make sure when you blow it out to keep it in the flame so you don't pop a bubble and floating glass goes everywhere. It's not good. Bad news. pop a little hole in the bubble. Hopefully it's right in the middle on the end, because then when you go to open it up, I just spin it out. Some people like to use a reamer and open it up, but I like to get my bubble nice and hot and then concentrate on that end hole. Make sure it doesn't close on you, because when you heat it up, it wants to close down, so gotta kind of blow it out every now and then. Damn. And you got a little dish. And then just wait till that cools down a little. Get my ball grabbers. Heat them up a little. Don't want to touch it to your hot glass. You'll get little cracks wherever the cold metal touches. So you don't want to heat the metal up too much either, because these things are really expensive. So just warm it up. Grab onto it. Tighten your little deal. And then I'm going to cut it off right here at the end. Gonna make that little nipple all smoothed out. So it's nice and even. It's all about the consistent spin. Most of the time you don't have to spin too fast unless you're trying to open something up like I just did. But like, you don't have to spin it super fast. Just gotta make sure you spin it evenly, so you're, you know, because gravity will make it want to flop. And in glass blowing, gravity is, you know, sometimes your friend and sometimes your worst enemy. So yeah, once you get that melted in pretty good, you got a little dish. So hold the incense in. Just go back to your raw tubing where I pulled that point out. Open up the end like I did on the last one. So you got something to blow through. I'm going to take another section of this tubing for the little base jar that's holding the tea light candle. Once you get it to the point where it's hot and kind of starts to slouch, don't want to pull too much right away. Definitely not while you're in the flame. Take it out of the flame. And then you want to pull, try to spin it while you pull so you get a nice even pull out of it. And you take it off right here at this end. Just like the last time. And I'm gonna pull that little nipple off so my bubble comes out smooth, not got a thick spot on the end. And this is another point, which we're gonna fume again with the Silva, get our colors matching. Get it kind of warm first. probably good. Sometimes this silver will pop off of the thing on you, so you want to like slowly heat it up a little bit. And once you heat it up, you can see sparks fly off, and that's all the impurities. And then you stick it in after that, so you don't get like weird dots and stuff all over your in your fume. You get a nice evenly fumed piece without funky spots in it. Oh, that one's nice, pretty. Nice blue. And then we're gonna blow this into a bubble. Same way as last time, make sure you heat it all evenly. Nice even spin. Also, you're like cooking that silver into the glass, so. Cause like if you just fumed it and then let it cool, you could probably like wipe that off a lot of the time, it's weird. So you gotta kinda cook that silver in. Once you get it hot, you blow a nice bubble out of it. Probably about good. Starts flopping on you. And then when I'm blowing, I'm not like blowing all crazy hard. I just keep it at like a constant pressure, and then once it cools down, then you know all the thin spots don't blow out too fast, and the thick spots don't, you know, it all comes out evenly, so you don't have any thicker spots or thinner spots. And I need to put a little wart on it and pop a hole in there and pull the other side. Okay, so I'm gonna do a little wart on the side. First, if you do it after you open up your bubble, then it wants to sink in on you and you can't blow it out because you already opened up your piece. So I'm gonna heat up my turquoise real good. And just the spot that I want to have my wart. Actually, that's gonna be the top, so. Okay. So I just heat that up real good. Maybe get a smaller flame going. Then you heat up the spot that you're gonna stick it. So it gets a nice weld on it. Lob it on there. And take it off. And you just want to heat that up nice and evenly without heating up the actual bubble too much, because you don't want to make the bubble disformed. But you don't want your little wart to be all funky either. So. And also, this is gonna have a hole in it for the stick of the incense, for the other kind of incense. So I'm heating that wart up real good, and I'm gonna kind of blow up into the wart. Once I get it all toasty and melted in to the point where I know it's got a good weld and whatnot. Get that little wart really hot, but not heat up the bubble, because you don't want to blow a hole in the side of your bubble where it's all thin and the wort's all thick. So let me like get the wort hot, but if possible not the bubble too hot. And then kind of once I pull it out, I'm going to wait a second so the thin spot of the bubble cools down before I blow into the wort. And then sometimes you'll have to take it and blow while you're in the flame. Like this. So yeah, now I got a bubble with a wort on it. Now I'm gonna open yeah, I'm gonna open up the end, I think. Yeah. Same way as I did last time with little tiny cutting flame. Try to make it right on the end, in the middle, centered. And then you kind of sometimes got to heat it up, make it open that hole up a little bit more so it doesn't close up on you. Like so. And then we're going to stick a plug in here so the hot air that's going up doesn't go through that tube and burn my hand. So yeah, then we're going to spin it open like last time. But not as wide as last time. This one's gonna be more like a jar shape than a dish shape. So wanna heat it up, spin it nice and evenly if you can, as even as possible, so your opening comes out nice and pretty. Like so. And then like, probably should check and see if that fits in there. Sweet. So yeah, now we got a little candle holder with the wort, with a little bit of a blown in spot on that wort. We're gonna make a little ash catcher for the stick type of incense. Okay. So got a fumed solid rod. I'm just going to put a couple stripes down it on one side. Maybe like three. Who knows? Whatever you feel is awesome. I'm gonna do six. Okay. Maybe one more. Yeah, okay, one more. So there. Made a pattern for the underneath side. You got one half with the stripes. And the other half is just, you know, normal rod. But yeah, there's your stripes. And then this half nice and clear, magnifies. It's gonna look awesome. So I'm just gonna like make it into a nice ball shape. So just wanna try to heat that up evenly and keep your pattern from twisting. So you keep that pattern on one side and the clear on the other side. So yeah, this is gathering it up on the end slowly. I'm gonna have to gather quite a bit of glass. Throw a little more fume. Actually, oh yeah. Fume it with silver on the same side that I did before. See, nice. Shiny silver fume. And I think I just put some dots on it. Do the stripes or the dots on the same side. I'm gonna let this small flame. I'm gonna melt all that into one huge ass. Oh, did I say ass? Huge, big marble and flatten it with the pattern side on the bottom. I know something else you could make out of this. Dishwasher safe. Put in the microwave. But only one color. Brown. I'm just kidding. That's not right. In the head. Get it all nice and hot. Let it gather into itself. And then you got a nice big ball of molten lava. I don't know if you can see when I turn that. Now that we have a nice big marble with little pattern on it that matches the other colors, little oil dish. Excuse me. We're gonna just take this, flatten it with the colored side on the bottom, and stretch it out into a little ash catcher, and bada bing. Hopefully, it'll be awesome. But yeah, you wanna get this all evenly heated, and then I'll probably start with the paddle on my carbon plate right here, and then maybe use the mashers. So gotta warm up your paddle a little bit, get it as hot as you can, and keep that pattern on the one side. And then just set it down with the pattern obviously on the bottom. So flip it over. Kind of flatten it out nice and, you know, start slowly so you don't accidentally get your pattern on, or if it gets, you know, just better to not try to smash it all in one smash sometimes, because, you know, better safe than sorry. Can't rush it. Can't rush art. So get it hot again. Smash that down. Now I can actually fit these around the the piece. Before, I would have just been making dents in the end of it, you know? So, once you get it flattened up enough to use your tiny little pair of mashers, just go and give it a little squish. Move it around a little bit. Try to get it flattened out pretty good. The end piece that's connected to your punty is always going to be the hard part to get with the smashers. Do it from the side sometimes. That works pretty good. So now we got it kind of flattened out, and it's kind of missing a pattern on that side, so I'm gonna just throw a little more on there real quick. I'm just gonna throw some dots all over it, or maybe I'll just swirl it around, because we're gonna stretch it out anyway. It's gonna look all cool. Go for the swirl pattern. Call it the brain. Give those dots and lines a stretch. They're not gonna look like dots and lines anymore. Get your nice pattern on there. Maybe I'll throw some extra dots with the head. Melt those pieces of clear squiggles and bumps all up in there so it's nice and smooth. And then once you get that melted in pretty much all the way, you probably don't even have to melt it in all the way, but you want to get it really close. But when you go to stretch it, it's going to be melted in, as long as you get those side, the end pieces because the middle's going to be stretching a lot more than the end. Okay, so now we have this flattened marbled with a pattern on the back of it and a magnifying clear glass on the front. Gives you a really crazy looking cool pattern. And now we're gonna take it, we're gonna heat it up in the middle mostly and grab onto it from this side. We get it nice and flat on that one side so we don't get a lumpy stretch. So I'm gonna heat that up, give it a little squish. Nice and soft all the way around. And that looks more even now from the side. Doesn't have to be too perfect, but you want to keep everything as even as possible, obviously. Make sure you kind of get it all hot. So you stretch. This end. This is my dance move. Thought that was harder than it was. So this one I'm just gonna give it a little tilt. Kind of heat that thick spot up. Kind of. Ah. And right there, I should have just went all the way and gave it that curve and then pulled it off at the same time. That's probably the way to do it. So you get a nice curve. So yeah, we're just gonna pretty much heat up each one of these really hot and stick this in there as evenly as possible so we get a good weld and it's not all crooked. So I'm gonna just actually connect them kind of one at a time, I think. Somewhat. I gotta go back to, there's little wrinkles in these every now and then if they were twisted while they were not hot enough or like cooled down in one spot, you get a little funky spot, so you gotta make sure you get nice welds and no little wrinklies. Pop the hole right here. Gotta kind of be quick of, since I have this all stuck together. Take off a little piece right there. Time. uno más. Perfect. I'm gonna kind of make this oblong, ovaly hole. Wow, that's a big candle. Pretty. Like a soul. And we'll grab that and give it a little pull.